I'm Dr. Steve Halstead, Michigan's state veterinarian. I'm here to tell you about how we test for bovine tuberculosis. Testing cattle for bovine TB is very much like testing people for TB. It's a multi-step process that begins with a screening test. The TB testing protocol is the same for beef and dairy cattle. The caudal fold tuberculin test, often called the CFT, is the primary screening test used for cattle. The caudal fold, as shown on this slide, is a skin fold on either side of the tail of the cow. Screening tests are designed to cast a wide net. This means that in addition to truly infected cattle, there will be a number that test positive but are not infected. These are called false positives. When conducting the caudal fold tuberculin test, a veterinarian injects a small amount of PPD tuberculin into the caudal fold. PPD is purified protein derived from bovine TB and is immunogenic. Immunogenic means it will stimulate the immune system. This means that if a cow has been exposed to bovine TB or related bacteria, it will recognize the PPD protein and respond with an immune response at the site of the injection. The veterinarian first loads one syringe for each cow to be tested, then injects the PPD tuberculin as shown on the right of this slide. The veterinarian evaluates the injection site for an immune response 66 to 78 hours after injection. The immune response can sometimes be very obvious and seen from a distance, but more often is subtle and only felt but not seen. Therefore, the evaluation involves both looking at the site and feeling the site. If there is no redness or swelling or bump, the animal is called CFT test negative, and no further testing is required. If there is redness or swelling or a lump or bump, the cow is said to have responded to PPD. Responding to PPD does not mean the animal has bovine TB and is not a definitive diagnosis of bovine TB. Responding to PPD means that the animal requires further testing. Most cattle that respond on the CFT do not have bovine TB. This slide shows two cows that responded to PPD. On the left is a dairy cow with a very small bump where the PPD was injected, and on the right is a beef cow with a large and visible response to PPD. Both animals responded to the PPD and require further testing. There are two different tests that may be used on cattle that respond to the CFT: the comparative cervical test, known as the CCT, and the gamma interferon test. Both tests compare the response to different kinds of TB. The CCT involves injecting the animal in the neck area, while gamma interferon is a blood test. The CCT requires two visits to the farm by our regulatory veterinarian, but the results are immediately available on the second visit. The gamma interferon test requires only one visit by the veterinarian, but the sample must be shipped to the laboratory and may take up to 10 days for results and interpretation. Only one of these tests may be used at a time in a herd. For the CCT, the neck is shaved in two places, as shown on the left of the slide. The skin thickness is measured with calipers and the thickness recorded for both places, as shown in the middle slide. Then the veterinarian injects avian or bird tuberculin into one shaved area and bovine or cattle tuberculin into the other shaved area. The tuberculin is injected between the skin layers or interdermally, as shown on the right. The skin thickness is again measured 66 to 78 hours after injection. Sometimes there is an obvious swelling where the bird or cattle tuberculin was injected, as shown on the left. Sometimes there doesn't appear to be any change, but the skin thickness when measured with calipers has increased compared to before the injection. In any case, the difference in skin thickness before and after injection is plotted on the official USDA CCT scattergram shown on the right. Based on where the response is plotted, the animal is either classified as negative, suspect, or reactor. Negative cattle require no further testing at that time. Cattle that respond to the CCT test require additional investigation depending on many things, including herd status, area of the state, and possibly other factors. The gamma interferon test is basically a test tube version of the CCT. It's done only on cattle, that is, no other species, that respond to the caudal fold test. It measures whether the animal's white blood cells can produce gamma interferon in response to different kinds of tuberculin. The results of the gamma interferon test can be negative or suspect. As with the CCT, negative cattle require no further testing at that time. Cattle that respond to the gamma interferon test require additional investigation depending on many things, including herd status, area of the state, and again, possibly other factors. Testing cattle for bovine TB assures Michigan's beef and dairy herds are healthy and that the food we produce is safe and plentiful.